Hi everybody, today we are breaking down five things to help you to start thinking spatially, which will lead to better decisions for you and your company. Let's go. So I am Katie Scheurer, and thank you for joining me on Project Spatial. I am really excited about this channel and we are just getting going and the response has been just so welcoming and amazing. I can't believe it. So if you don't want to miss a thing, make sure that you go down into the links and sign up for the newsletter from my website. And then also make sure you subscribe and ring the bells. Number one is visual thinking. So 60% of people are visual thinkers and they like to see pictures and they like to experience things visually because it makes more sense to them in a quicker way. Being able to use visuals allows you to express very complex information and complex ideas very quickly. People can take in the information very quickly, make easy assumptions, and kind of move on. So for an example, I was looking around on the Esri Story Map Gallery, which I will link below, and I found a affordable housing index map, which I thought was kind of cool. You know, we all need homes and need to be able to find affordable housing. And if you're looking to move somewhere, this would be something that would be very useful. I want you to notice that they used color very strongly. So the blue that is on this map shows housing that is more affordable. And the white is showing housing that is about the average for the national for affordability. And then red is showing less affordable areas. I thought this was a very informational map just because from one click glance, you can kind of get encapsulate the whole country and get a feel for the entire country. And you can immediately start making decisions based on what you would want to do if you were trying to change affordability of housing, or if you were providing luxury items and you wanted to target people that maybe had a little bit more expendable income because they are not spending so much on their home. So you want to start asking where. And a lot of people think like, well, duh, you're thinking spatially, but there's a lot of people out there that are dealing with mass amounts of data, but they never stop to think about where are these data points, where in the planet does this affect, and how are other things going on in that location affecting my data results. Number three, to start thinking spatially, is use your critical thinking skills. One thing that I think is kind of lacking in many areas is critical thinking. You want to make sure that you are questioning the resources that you have. You're questioning, why are we doing something this way? Why do we do this workflow this way? Why are we managing our data this way? What's the purpose behind collecting all of these different attributes and everything? Is there a report that needs to be generated? Is there a workflow that needs to be maintained? Does this data need to be maintained indefinitely? Or is this information something that we're going to use once and then toss because we just used it for that one project? These are things that you want to consider when you're starting to use spatial data, because the way you store that information and the way you take care of it is going to completely change on the value of that information and the longevity that is needed. Number four, to start thinking spatially, is to get to know your customer. Now, I think this is something that as a GIS person, we can kind of struggle with. We get kind of locked in our corners, you know, whether we're just in our little office or we're constantly behind our computer, and we need to be there. We're doing a lot of important work and that's how we get our stuff done. But when you're trying to press forward your program and you want to start creating a strategic plan, you need to know your customers. Now, for a lot of us, our customers are going to be our coworkers. essentially, they're going to be the people that are using your information. So your customer might not be the company's customer, or if you work for a state or government organization, it might not be your citizens that you're serving, but actually it's the internal customers, it's the internal coworkers that you are working with. Start collecting spatial data. Now, I spoke before about start thinking about location and collecting location on the information that you're collecting, but as you know, GIS is a collaborative thing. You can't create a map with all the information you need just by yourself. It would take you forever. You never get anything done. So you want to be able to start collecting your data resources. Now, this could mean that you're going to the Esri Living Atlas, which has a ton of information, and there's so much more information that's getting added every day. It's really quite impressive, everything that's out there. And if you want to let me know down below, I would be really interested. What kind of information are you dealing with on a day-to-day basis? All right, that's all I got for you guys today. If you liked this video, please give me a little bit of a like and share this out on LinkedIn. Make sure to subscribe and sign up for my newsletter so you really don't miss a thing. Thank you so much. Bye.